First of all, the first half, you know, what were you feeling as you went at halftime?
Yeah, we kind of did everything right, apart from, you know, scoring, putting the ball in the back of the net. But we knew that if we kept going, we'd eventually get there, and we did.
What was said at halftime?
Just that, you know, like, you know, we had many shots on goal. We didn't really concede much at the back, and, you know, if we just kept at it, we'll get it.
Yeah, you set up those first two goals, sort of different types of crosses. Did it feel good to sort of, you know, having been wearing the armband to sort of contribute like that?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I led the boys out, and it was a very special moment for me and my family. But I've always, you know, tried to improve that side of the game, and, you know, I'm happy that I got the two assists.
Did it feel different starting with Chris on the field?
Yeah, especially, you know, he is a big presence for us. I thought Wayne did very well, you know, filling in. You know that sometimes there's not going to be players that are there, and, you know, everyone's got to be fine, and I think everyone did.
I think there are eight of you starting who are 24 or younger. Did it feel like this was the real chance to show what you guys are about as footballers, and how good does it feel to have, you know, done that before anyone?
Yeah, you know, to score four goals is very big, and it was nice to play on a very good surface. You know, we kind of showed, you know, New Zealand fans that, you know, we've got a very good generation at the moment and to come. So as long as we keep that up, it's a very exciting future for us.
What does it mean to you? You sort of touched on it. What does it mean to you walking on that field as captain at home?
Yeah, it was first time, you know, captaining my country at home. It was a very special moment, and one that, you know, I cherished, and it was just a special moment for me to, you know, lead this special group. You know, we've got a great group of players at the moment, young and old, and it was a very, very honouring moment for me.
Does it inspire you?
Yeah, and hopefully I inspired, well, not just me, but the team inspired, you know, the young fans that came out to watch us. You know, we're thankful that we got a good turnout here, and hopefully for the next month we can, you know, continue that.
How were the conditions?
Oh, the conditions were immaculate, you know.
Chilly,
yeah, but most of the boys, you know, some of them play in Scandinavia, in the UK, they're used to it. But, you know, in comparison to what we had a couple of days ago, you know, it was a carpet out there, and the boys appreciated it.
And it looked like in the last 10 minutes of the first half that there was some frustration building. You were sort of, well, what do we have to do here? How do you sort of avoid that, not getting too frustrated?
Yeah, it was a bit of a unique situation for us. You know, sometimes we don't create a lot, and but I thought, you know, it was very positive that we created so many chances. I think they did get lucky in the first half a lot. I think we could have scored three or four. But, you know, we're just happy that we got the four goals in the end, and, you know, put a show on for the fans.
Just lastly, what have you made of Silverise? You know, plenty of times down the left, and was you two sort of combining. And, yeah, he had plenty of sort of dangerous runs at times.
Yeah, I love playing with Oldie. I love playing whoever's on my left side. But, you know, he's playing out in Saint-Étienne in France, and you can see what technique, what skill he has, and, you know, I enjoy playing with him, and he's a great player and a great kid.
You looking forward to building that combination with him over the next little while?
Yeah, for sure. It's an exciting future, especially for me and for him on the left. You know, he's young, he's still got a lot to learn, but at the moment I'm enjoying playing with him.